Well, guys, we're going duck hunting this morning. My buddy Greg, he's got a flooded field that he said it's covered up, so got the old layout blinds out. We're gonna go give it a shot, see what happens. 5:40. First shooting light is at 6:55. It's just right here down the road. But we're gonna get out there, set the decoys up, and hopefully some ducks come in. In this flooded field, so I guess I'm going whitetail on these ducks. Make sure they're not wet from yesterday. All right, guys, we're gonna get set up. Sun's about to come up, so hopefully we get some ducks in here.
Baby.
Well, the ducks aren't really doing what we want them to. They're all landing in this pond behind this flooded field, and there's a perfect little dam, so we're gonna walk up behind that dam, see if we can't jump shoot some of them. God, I hadn't shot this morning, so I'm gonna let him shoot. So I'm gonna hold the camera and shoot.
Good shot, Kyle.
Good shot, dude.
All gaddies.
Well, we got four. That's what you call a Texas jump shoot right there.
Later.
That left side looked like it dipped a little.
We're just standing around talking, standing up, and two widgeon come flying through. Me and Greg shot one, and we hit the other one three times, and he got about 100 yards, and Kyle was laying down, jumped up, made about a 100-yard shot. It's pretty crazy, but I think we got 10 ducks now. We're gonna sit here for a little longer, maybe an hour or so, see what happens. Well, that's gonna wrap it up, guys. We're gonna go home, clean these ducks up, and make some lunch. All right, guys, made it back to the house. Greg took a few ducks, and I took a few. Widgeon are really good to eat. Gadwall are not my favorite, but that's all right. Teal are my favorite. If you ever shoot a teal, definitely cook them up. But I'm gonna cook all these. What I do is just take the skin on the breast and just tear it apart with your thumbs and then just work it back all the way down the breast until you can see the whole breast. You don't have to pluck them or anything like that unless you want like a full duck. So get them like that, and you just make a cut down either side of the that little breastplate, and then you want to cut on either side. And you just kind of work it down like a back strap on a deer. They got a little tenderloin in there, it's really good. And that's a half of a duck breast. You want to try to keep as many feathers off of the meat as possible. It's not possible, but try your hardest. So that's how I clean my ducks. It's pretty simple. There's a million different ways to clean them. I've done it where you step on the head and tail and pull the wings and the whole breast comes out, but then you still gotta take it off the bone. Some people have to do that for transport. You have to keep a wing on it, but I just brought the whole ducks home, so I don't have to do that. But there's a million different ways. This is what I've found is the easiest. Plucking a duck is not fun. You do get more meat, but I don't really like legs on a duck. It's not my favorite thing, so I try not to mess with that too much. I'll do it every now and then, but this is my favorite way to clean a duck. So I'm gonna cook them how I cooked the deer meat the other night. I know a lot of y'all were asking if I could do a voiceover on how I do it. But I'm just gonna do it with this duck because it's just as good. So I'm gonna get these cleaned up and I'll meet you in the kitchen. All right, guys, all cleaned up. Got me a shower in. Let's see what I need. Show you what I got going here. Minute rice, 1 cup of rice, 1 cup of water. microwave. Let that go. Got some butter in here. Half an onion and then some green peas that are chopped up. Throw these onions and peas in. That start browning up. You want those to get brown and cooked before you put it in the rice. Then you want to take your duck breast, clean it off, and then just cut it into little bite-sized pieces. I'm not using all the ducks we shot, but just enough for my wife and I for lunch. And normally I'll take my duck breast and soak them in Coke for a couple hours or even overnight. It really takes the gaminess out of them, but I like duck, so I don't have a problem cooking them without marinating them. A lot of people will soak them in salt water or buttermilk, and I don't think it changes the taste, but Coke, you can definitely tell the difference in Coke. So the onions and peas are cooked. I'm gonna throw your duck in. The rice is done too, so you save that for that. Once your duck to start cooking, you're gonna take Worcestershire, put a little bit of that. Just a little bit of soy sauce. And then this squeezed ginger. I love ginger. And a little bit of minced garlic. I don't know, that much. Only that doesn't look delicious. So you just let your duck cook. You don't want to overcook your duck. It gets really tough and not very good, so I usually do about a medium rare. I'm cooking. I'm gonna take your rice, start mixing that in, turn your heat off. I could have done more rice, but that's all right. And that's it. I don't even know what you call it, duck fried rice? The only thing that's missing is sriracha. It's so good on it, but I don't have it. If you don't like duck, try this, because it is good. Super good. So that's the end of this video. Thanks for watching. Hit the subscribe, hit the thumbs up, and remember, eat good.